Okay, today we're gonna trim the edge. The edge provides clean cuts because applies pressure to the materials. It's spring-loaded. And you can take it out easy, and you can use the truck as an edge guide. Sometimes you have to do that. Okay, so let me clean the edge one time. I'm gonna do a back cut, but you have to be very careful. You only want to lower the blade by 16 below the plastic. Okay, let me do that. Right here. And I lower by 16 below the plastic. Right here. And like it. Now, I don't want to destroy the wood too. So, I'm bringing this here so the plastic always is under support. You don't want to cut the plastic here. You want to have some support here. Even if I have a small table, I can still do that. So, let me start this here. Okay, now that I'm here, I'm just reset my guide because I don't have the space. Start all over again. Okay, and I'm pushing my edge. If I have a larger table here set up, then I don't have to stop. When I restart my cut, it's fine right here. I don't want this blade to touch anything. Okay, so that's how I restart my cut. You ready? That's it. So, I suggest you have a long table or long piece of wood to do that. Okay. Now that I clean the edge, I can make a cut on the AC2 that we have one somewhere around here. That insert. You see the plastic gives you clean cut on the left side of the blade. Now with this insert, you can see here, Smart Base Anti-Chip 2. R for right. Okay, I'm pushing this in. Stops right here. It clicks right on it. Okay, you have to lift this up, of course. Now, let me show you the problem with this. Okay, now, so, all the way, come to the very end. Right here, I don't want to destroy the wood, and I have to make my cut. Because you don't want one plastic to ride on top of the other plastic. You want the plastics to be like this. I'm not going all the way down because I have the aluminum here. This is not the right table to do that, but that's what I have. So now I'm gonna show you what I did. I just clean up this edge over here. And actually you're gonna go all the way, you're gonna clean it all the way up to here. But now, we're still gonna have one minor problem. And I'll tell you how to fix it. Okay. Now, you see when I try to make my cut here, Let me see if everything is free. You're gonna see the saw try to lift up because of the plastic of the insert. Okay, you see? Right here. The insert lifts the saw up like that. So you don't want that. What you do, you take it out and you remove this area from here to here with the sandpaper or a utility knife sideways, few times, 2-3 times. As long as this is cut all the way, you must cut this all the way. Then you have to remove enough materials and do a tryout a few times, maybe 2-3 times. So this way your saw don't lift up right here. Right here. Okay. So we got the AC1 and AC. Let's do the AC1 now. This one is made for right and left. We are using right blade saw. We're taking this out. Putting this in. Right here, you wanna hear that click. Okay, you see the stopper here? It stops right here. You wanna know that. Okay? Now, I will make a minor cut. Let's see if I have a scrap piece of wood somewhere here. No? I'm just gonna make it. Yes, I do. I'm gonna make a cut right here. Actually, all the way. You wanna go all the way with this. And I'm gonna show you a few tricks. Okay? You hold this here and go very slow. Now, right here, if you use a micrometer or a straight edges, you're gonna see that there is a small hump. It's not even. You can see with the straight edge, there is not even. You can see there's a valley over here, high spot, low spot, and here is sometimes is another high spot for the left bladed saws. So, what you do here, you remove this high spot area again with the sandpaper. 2-3 passes is enough to fix that issue. So they are not problems, they're actually designed like that in case you change saws and, you know, and stuff like that. And that's it for the edges and the inserts. Thank you.